I'm telling you, I think we have to be careful what we wish for, what we pray for, because it's got to be, if it's okay with the universe. I have a friend, she used to say, I can make it happen. I just can't make it work out.
Oh, yeah. And
I mean, in my life, how many times I have self-willed things, I have wanted a certain guy, and by God, I've gotten it. It has not worked out. I have gotten a lot of stuff, and I don't do that anymore. So I think you have to be careful. It has to be for the higher good, and it has to be something that will not just be a Cadillac. You know,
oh,
it can't
100%.
Be about... It can't be about material things. It has to be about how, you know, how we can be of service in the world. Because that's, in my experience of my many, many years, and I'm getting really old now, the only thing that makes me happy in life is being of service. None of the rest of it, all the rest of it is just stuff to do between hugs. That's the truth.
Beth. I love that. But it's true, though. It's really true, because I find it's funny you say that, because I've been thinking about it. I'm in my mid to late 30s. And so it's like I think about that a lot lately, like the things that I've tried to force to make happen. It's just never been the right thing. But the things that I have said, OK, what's the good I can put into the world? Where am I supposed to be right now? And let me stand firm in that. That's when the beautiful things have happened. The like soul filling type things have happened.
And I do all this footwork. I like to call it footwork instead of like goal oriented, going to get that thing. And I do this footwork in all these different directions. And then something floats in on a silver platter that I least expected, which if any of those things had happened, I wouldn't have been able to do. So I don't know. There's something about energy creates energy. And I do think that I don't mean to be so, I'm not holier than thou at all. I also, all of these things that I do that are positive and toward love, toward the higher good, have only allowed me to survive. These are survival tactics. You know, I always say about people in show business, they either become alcoholic drug addicts or they get deeply spiritual and they find some center, whether it's yoga or church or whatever it is. You've got to find a way to deal with this crazy business. So my way has been to, you know, find out how I can be of service for the greater good, you know, but it's not, I have learned painfully, time after time, that my ego is not my amigo.